What's good, everybody? Welcome in. If you're watching this on YouTube or Facebook, make sure you leave a like. Say replay in the chat if you're watching the replay. How many orders do we have going out today? I haven't even checked. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. We have 8 orders going out the door. Remember, in 40 minutes, we're starting our Whatnot show for suicide awareness. So you'll hear me mention that a couple times in the live. We got it all set up, ready to go. We're just waiting on our time. What's up, Joel? I need some energy this morning. I am tired now. What's up, Chelsea? Welcome in. What's up, Joel? Joel, you might have been, I don't know, between you and Chelsea, you guys were like right neck and neck. I guess you get first on TikTok, she'll be first on Facebook. What's up, Bobby? 8 sales going out the door, 2 eBay, 2 Poshmark, and 4 Mercari. 4 Mercari yesterday. I would have had 5, but somebody's payment didn't go through. I kept accepting their offer. They kept sending the offer over and over again. I kept accepting it. It wouldn't go through. So, what's up, Vintage? What's up, Angie? Angie's in the house. Angie, I almost read your name as Angry. If you ain't first, you last. What's up, Marge? Heidi, what's up? You win, Chelsea. I give you first place. Joel came come in a close second, very close second. All right. 8 orders going out the door. We'll give it a couple more seconds for everybody. Hop on in here. If you're new here, hit that follow button top left-hand corner. I do these lives every single morning. I show you guys what sold. I do lives at night going over the listing process, or we hang out, answer questions. Feel free to ask your questions in the chat during this live. I have to make this live quick. It's got to be done in 40 minutes because I have to go do the Whatnot show. So what's up, Kit Kat? Do you pay to sell on eBay? You pay a fee if your item sells on eBay. Yes. Yeah, Mercari's going off. Yesterday, Mercari went off. Absolutely went off. Don't drink those monsters. I went to the gym and negates it. Like if you go to the gym and you drink a monster, it's like you never did it. What's up, Sarah? Good morning, Clip. Don't drink those monsters. Don't drink soda. 5th today, I'll take it. Nice. Did I miss anybody? Oh, I didn't miss anybody. Heart from Turtle Cam, aka Poshman. What's up? What happened, Felix? What happened? Good morning, Erica. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Be like Ethan. Be like Ethan. Don't drink any sodas. Let me close this. This is super duper bright. I can barely even see the screen. There we go. It might be a little bit darker, but yeah. No soda. All right, let's go ahead and get started. First up, we'll do our Poshmark sales, which are right here. First Poshmark sale was this Sundance. It's like a turtleneck hoodie looking thing. Oh, let me slide you guys over really quick so I can read this chat. What's up, Elliot? Lane's in the house. Eva's in the house. Cindy's here. Almost forgot that. I guess I'll have to do something. Watch while I do laundry. There you go. What's up, Patriot Girl? All right, first sale was this Sundance. It's a turtleneck, like, pullover. It's not a hoodie, but it's like a pullover. This sold on Poshmark for $22. We paid $4.28 for it at a thrift store. So after fees, shipping, cost of goods, we make $13.32. And we literally just listed this last week. So it sold within a week, which is great. Not a huge profit, but every time we pick up Sundance, it usually sells pretty quick for us. Another replay. You already know, Scott. You already know. All right, this one is going right into one of these Tyvek envelopes. I get these free from USPS.com. I use them for all of my Poshmark shipping usually, unless it's a bigger item and it goes into a box. Take that, fold it over, take a piece of tape, tape it down. It's good to go. Cindy says, nice. Nice. All right, that one is shipped. We got one more Poshmark sale. This is a really good sale, really good brand to be on the lookout for. The brand, I know it's backwards for you guys. The brand is Grayson, G-R-A-Y-S-O-N, G-R-A-Y-S-O-N. This is a long sleeve top. Sorry, I got a burp. Long sleeve top. I paid $4.28 for this one. This sold for $40. It's in pre-owned condition, sold for $40. So after fee, shipping, cost of goods, I make $27.72. Really good brand. It always sells super fast. What's up, Gigi? Really good brand, always sells super fast for us. I think we're actually sold out of these now. We don't have any more listed. Just like a couple weeks ago, we had 2 or 3 of these listed, and they've all sold. So be on the lookout for Grayson. Good luck today with Whatnot. Appreciate you, Scott. Should be a lot of fun. We already have the show loaded up, so go bookmark it. Go check out what we have loaded. We got lots of goodies loaded up today. And then, of course, all the proceeds not the proceeds, 20% of the profit goes towards suicide awareness. We're putting up $100 to start out with, and then any tips we get during the show will go directly towards the cause. Could you help me pricing a Dixon? I looked it up, and it says it's an OG royalty, but I'm not sure. The name should be right on the tag. If you look up that exact tag, you should find that exact pattern on eBay. Those are super easy to look up. We're confirming it's a royalty. The tag, it should say Dixon, and then it should say the name of the actual Dixon flannel, the actual edition it is, right below. You just type that in, and you can see exactly what those are listed for. Are you doing a Saturday whatnot this week? We are. I got to load it up actually right after this. I forgot to do that. So pumped for the raid train. Thank you for participating. Yeah, Sarah, what I'm going to do is all the money that we raise, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tip you during your show. So that way you can just collect it that way if that's cool with you. And then I feel like if people see me tipping like $100, $100, $100, whatever we tip, like that'll make people want to tip too. So we'll be able to get more money towards it. So if that's cool with you, instead of doing the whole Venmo thing, since whatnot doesn't take any fees anyway, I'll just tip you that way and then you can collect it. What's up, Amy? Thank you so much for supporting a good cause. Hey, it's not my idea. I'm just here to help the cause. So don't give me any of the credit. The credit goes to Sarah, who's in the chat over on TikTok. She gets the credit. And I think Callahan is the other person that set up the raid train. So both of them get credit. I told them use me however you want to use me. And they wanted me to go first. So I'm going first. So however they wanted to use me, I'm being used. That works for me. Okay, cool. That's what we'll do. Next up, we got a Hudson pair of jeans. These are brand new with tags. These sold on Mercari for $56. I paid $25.67. These are retail arbitrage, which means I bought them from a retail store to resell back online. These made me a profit of $14.31. Jeans are starting to move, people, so get your jeans listed. I've had these listed for about 6 months. I bought them at the end of the season last year. I knew they would take a while to sell, and now they're finally starting to move. So that's great. This just went in a padded flat rate. I bought my label off pirateship.com. If you don't know what Pirate Ship is, watch my reel two TikToks ago, and it'll talk all about Pirate Ship during that video. That one shipped. Next up, we have a Ralph Lauren. Ralph Lauren's have been moving for me, especially the long sleeve ones. This is a Ralph Lauren. It's a 2XL. It's a newer, not the newest label, but a newer label. That's key for these. Always pick up the newer labels. I paid $7.13 in a bulk buy for this. It sold for $24 after fees, shipping costs, goods. Makes $7.05. I really got to price these a little bit higher on Mercari. If this would have sold on eBay, I would have made over $10. But because I get free shipping on Mercari and I take offers, Mercari's fees are really high. So I need to pay attention to that. But still, $7. I paid $7 for it. It sold relatively quick. But I probably should have took a little bit more for it. Have you ever heard of Woolex? Woolex. No, I don't think I've ever heard of Woolex. Is it a brand? What's up, Lorenzo? I've had 3 sales so far this week, which is great for my little store. Awesome, Amy. Let's go. Appreciate the roses, Lorenzo. Lorenzo, I was going to hit you up about that pressure washer that you found. We need to go to Lowe's. I think it's Lowe's, right? It's Lowe's, right, Lorenzo? Lowe's and get a pressure washer. They're only like $50 for a pressure washer. They're on clearance. Yeah. Yeah. If we can't find one, Lorenzo, I might hit you up and just pay. It's at Lowe's. I might hit you up and ask you what you want for it, and then I'll buy it off you. But we need to go check out Lowe's maybe tomorrow. See if we can find one. Because we need a pressure washer. I need to pressure wash the outside of my house. What's up, Desti? Blue cheese bestie in the house. She loves herself. Desti is a blue cheese fan. I'm starting to convert her over. She messaged me yesterday and she said, I love blue cheese. That's all she said. Right, Desti? Next up, this is a polo Ralph Lauren. It's a 3XLT polo. And it has the embroidery on the front. It's a really, really nice piece. We paid $7.13 also in that bulk buy. Sold for $34 after fee, shipping costs, because make $15.22. I'll send it to you for what I got it for. Lorenzo, I got to make you some money. Just let me know what you want for it. I'll send you PayPal or something. Hit me up or I'll hit you up after this. After my whatnot show, I'll hit you up. And I want to make you some money too. I don't want you to just sell it to me for what you got it for. You got to make some money too. Hi, is there an app you use to keep track of your purchase prices and sale price? So I use a spreadsheet. It's Jason Hayes spreadsheet. Nicole, it's in my pin post. If you go to my pin post on Facebook, go to my link tree there. His spreadsheet is linked in that link tree. That's the one I use. Keeps track of all my inventory, keeps track of my sales, keeps track of my profit and loss, all that good stuff. Any pressure washer too? Lowe's didn't have any. Damn it. Need to find one. Need to find one. Well, I got a cool guy named Lorenzo. He's going to sell me one. Right, Lorenzo? He's going to sell it to me. He got like 65 of them. Is there an app you use to keep... Oh, no, I just answered that. Gotcha. Gotcha. You buy the clear bags for the shirts? Yes. They're also... You go over on TikTok to my link tree. They're in my link tree. Products we use on a daily basis. All the products you normally see in all these videos that I'm using are all linked in that link tree. I'm missing so much in chat. We got... We'll talk. Okay, cool. I love Dusty. Yes, and she loves blue cheese. She loves it. Ralph Lauren is one of those timeless brands. Yes, I'm starting to love it. I used to never pick up Ralph Lauren, but shout out to Surf's Up Finds. He got me into Ralph Lauren again, and I'm so glad because Ralph Lauren is starting to turn into one of my best-selling brands. It might actually be my best-selling brand this year. Last year was Tommy Bahama, but this year I think it's going to be Ralph Lauren just because I've been picking up so many of them. What's up, Thrifty Finds? Good morning. Last Mercari sale, again, 4 Mercari sales yesterday. These Peter Millar pants, they are brand new with tags. I picked these up for $25.68. They sold for $50. They sold in 2 days after I listed them. Made a profit of $12.56. Not a huge profit. This is a retail arbitrage pickup. But to pay $25 and make $12, almost $13 in profit in 1 day is perfect. So I'm completely fine with that when it comes to retail arbitrage. Peter Millar, money. Definitely money. Good morning, good finds. Appreciate everybody hanging out. Remember, we have our Whatnot show at 11 for the suicide awareness raid train. So be there, be square. We got everything loaded up. So go bookmark the show. It should be a lot of fun. I hope things go for steals and deals. There's probably not going to be a lot of people there, which is completely fine with me. The show is not about making money. To be honest, if I break even, I'm completely fine with it. It's more about the cause and having a little bit of fun and starting the raid train off right. So be there, be square. We got some giveaways loaded up, and you never know what I'm going to do. You never know if I'm feeling froggy, and I might load up some more stuff to give away. I'm trying to be like you, my boy. You the blueprint? I'm not the blueprint. I'm just doing what everybody else taught me to do. I learned all my stuff from free content online, just like you're watching right now. I had 2 on Mercari. I always think the world is off. It's access when that happens. I know. Yesterday, Desti, I had 4 Mercari, 2 Poshmark, 2 eBay. Mercari carried me yesterday. I don't know what happened. And I would have had a 5th Mercari if the person that made the offer actually had their correct payment set up. So those sweaters behind you, you should see all of them that I have. You must be new here. All underneath that jacket. Oh, we got to grab that jacket really quick. Can you throw me that Lululemon jacket? I got to ask you guys a question, all you Lululemon experts in the chat. So mom went to Goodwill and she found this Lulu jacket. It's definitely an older one. I want you guys to look at it and tell me if you think it's legit, when it's from. So there's the top of the Lulu jacket, right? Yeah, see that top of the Lulu jacket. Here's the front. Let me scoop. Watch it. Watch yourself. Here's the front of the Lulu jacket. It has these little things on it. See the little aglets on it? It has the Lulu hit right there on the front. But the only thing that's off to me, you see how that one, I think it's actually, if it's legit, I don't know. It has an orange one here and a gray one below. And then on this side, it has 2 gray ones, 2 gray interior ones. Is Lulu counterfeit often? Yes. Yes, Lulu is counterfeited often. The only thing, other thing that was throwing me off is this. There's a tag on the inside, and this is a coin part, and it has 5, 10, and 25 cents. We've tried to Google image it, but it's just gray. It pulls up a whole bunch of them. That's the only other thing that's throwing me off. Does older Lulu have this in it? This is definitely an older piece. So what do you guys think? Lulu has the hit right there. Definitely older because it has the hexagon. That's what the little aglet looks like. And then that's what that looks like. So if anybody knows, Angel says legit. So I don't know. I think it's just an older piece before they started being mainstream because they were older, definitely. It's an older piece. I have the exact one. Boom. It's real, just old.
It's a scuba, right?
It's a scuba. It's a scuba, but it's old. They probably didn't even call these scubas when they first made them. I'm assuming that this is actually worth more money because it feels heavier, more quality. And this is like when they first started making Lululemon. That's what I thought. Yes, hooded scuba. Okay, you're good. This was her first find, by the way, at Goodwill. This was mom's first find. We have taught her well. 1 week after, she's finding Old scuba hoodies. Old scuba hoodies. Look at that, Mom. You got everybody saying good job.
I'm so excited. Thank you.
She's gonna list that. We're gonna set her up with an eBay account probably later on this week. That'll be her first listing. And hopefully it sells really quick for her. She makes some extra money.
Cool.
I think too with the zipper covers, yeah. Yeah, I think it's good. I think it's good to go. That's what I figured. I figured it was just an older piece. I tried to look it up, but it was like impossible to find the exact one. We found ones that were very similar, but not the exact one. How do you figure the style of Lululemon, something like this? So use Google image search is the easiest way. If you have like a Lulu piece with like a pattern on it, it's super easy to do. You just go to Google image. You can download the Google app on your phone, use the image search, just take a picture of your item and it'll pull up a bunch based off the image that you take. Sometimes you have to take a couple different images to get the exact one correctly, but yeah, that's how we do it. Good morning, K-Way. Driving to the 9 to 5. Great job, Mom. Get that knowledge. Let's go, Peter. Bought mine for Poshmark for $65. 65. You hear that?
Yes.
She paid $10 for it. Or I'm going to tell her to list it for 80 because I think it's a pretty rare piece. Love that you're helping her. I have so many stay-at-home mom friends. I taught her how to resell. Yeah, Candy, if you're just coming in, she actually helps us out now. She works for us during the day, and then she goes to Goodwills by night now. She looks for stuff to resell. So that's awesome. She's making a little money on the side. Put those sweaters on Depop. I'm just going to have her, I'm going to teach her eBay first. I'm not going to teach her all those other ones. I think Marshalls has any finds. Yes. Marshalls does have finds. You can find some stuff. Sometimes you got to go to multiple stores. So also I just sold an older one on Poshmark as well for 55. Let's go. How do you calculate shipping for pieces in your store? I'm curious. Most of the items in my store are under a pound. So if they're under a pound, they'll be between $5 to $6. If they're over a pound, usually I'll charge shipping on those pieces, or I'll just guesstimate shipping based off the weight. So if it's between 1 and 2 pounds, the most expensive it'll probably be shipping to somewhere like California or Hawaii is going to be like $12. So you just factor that in. Yeah, she's carrying right now. Dusty says you're carrying just like normal, back there working hard. Dusty, she made me go to the gym today, okay? I've already worked enough for today. That's enough. I literally woke up out of bed. First thing I did. Yeah, she did have to wake me up because I was so tired from going to the gym yesterday. And I literally woke up and just went right to the car. Didn't even have my shoes on yet. And I had to go to the gym. That's a very evil place. I don't know why people even go there. It's not a place for... Yeah, exactly. Dusty. She said, wait, dot, dot, dot. That's horrible. It is horrible. Next up, it's a Ralph Lauren shirt. Paid $7.13 for this. This sold for $20 plus shipping over on eBoy. Did y'all get donuts on the way back home? No, I had to do a bulk buy on the way back home. I had to meet up with my bulk buy guy. There we go. Dusty just sent me a donut. Thanks, Dusty. No, but I am drinking a Monster. It offsets the gym. It's like I didn't even go now. That's okay with me. I used to drink a Monster and not go to the gym, so it works. Won a $50 giveaway on Poshmark sending offers to likers in my closet. Nice. Somebody who uses Autoposher, Trisha, she won a $50 giveaway or a $100 giveaway because Autoposher was just relisting for her, and she wanted the list, won one of the listing challenges. What's up, Reselling Nostalgia? Long time no see. Appreciate you hopping in. You're over on Facebook too. That's a little different. Over on Facebook. That's a no. It's a no for me, dog. I know. Dusty, we're in this together, Dusty, okay? I like how we just made that connection right there. This one's shipping for $4.88. Appreciate the heart me thumper split. I drink energy drinks every day and go to the gym every day. I approve. There we go. I think I have to drink the sugar-free ones, right? That's what you're really supposed to do. But I don't like the sugar-free ones. What's a thermal printer? I use a Dymo 4XL. I do not suggest to get the 5XL. Please don't buy it. It's a scam because you have to buy the Dymo labels with it. If you want to buy a cheap one, I have an IDPRT printer linked in my bio. A bunch of people in the community use that one, and they say it's really good and it's really cheap. So I have it linked in my bio with the labels that I use linked in my bio too. Good morning, Raphael. I drink the white sugar-free Monsters. I've never had that one. I had a sugar-free Red Bull the other day, and it was disgusting. Finally got my name on Instagram and Facebook. Nice. Next up, last sale we're packing up. This is a Ralph Lauren. Sold really fast. It's a Polo Ralph Lauren Polo, but it's a great size. It's size 3XB. Paid $4.82. This one sold for $22.49 plus shipping. Sold really fast. Bread and butter sale. Good size. Just a normal print on this, but the size is what sold it. Also, the fact that it's a performance polo. What about figures? Do you sell any mostly clothes? Mm-hmm. I sell mostly clothing. Mostly clothing. Try the Alani brand drink. Sugar-free. Is that the one that The Rock makes? Is that the one? What's the one that The Rock makes? I tried that one too and it was disgusting. I tried it when it first came out. And it was nasty. All right, that one is in a bag. Throw it on the scale. It weighs 12 ounces. It's based out of Australia. Okay, I'll have to try it. Alani. Alani. I'm always up for trying something that's still does the same thing, but it's a little bit healthier. Alani or Ghost, never turn it back. Okay, Alani. I'll have to try that one. Don't think there's one that The Rock makes. I forget what the name of that one was. When it first came out, I drank it, but it was bleh, it's nasty. This one shipping for 12 ounces for $5.04. Shipping out. Zoe, yeah, that one. Zoe, however you pronounce it. Explain shipping calculations once more. So if it's under a pound, it's going to go ground advantage, which means it's going to ship for anywhere between $5 to $6. If it goes really close to you, you might get under $5, depending on the weight. If it's over a pound, it's going to go usually priority or UPS for me is how I ship those. Typically, I try to just pick priority. Even if priority is like a little bit more expensive than UPS, I'll still pay for priority because my mailman comes to my front door. It saves me a trip to the run into the UPS store. So yeah, over a pound is priority UPS, under a pound is USPS ground advantage. What about shipping on shoes? Same thing. It's either mean ground advantage, shipping on shoes, priority mail, or UPS. You have to choose which one's the cheapest. Is the Whatnot Show loaded? Yes, it is loaded. Go check it out. It's loaded up right now. Everything is loaded up. Hopefully we don't have a ton of people there. You guys can get some steals and deals. We got two giveaways we'll be doing, and maybe I'll throw some more giveaways in. In 19 minutes. We'll be there in 19 minutes. I love shipping shoes on Poshmark. Facts. Shipping shoes on Poshmark is so nice because buyers get a great deal because they only have to pay like $8, $9 for shipping. I think it's like $8.95. And if you sold those same shoes on eBay and you charge the buyer shipping, it normally is over $10. So they get a good deal. The only issue is they take 20%. But in most cases, if you price a little bit higher, buyers will still pay for that price and you still make the same amount of money and buyers get a better deal. What's up from Brazil? I think that's what you said. I don't know how to read that. But what's up, Brazil? What's up, Brazil? Over 4 pounds. I go back to ground advantage. Yeah. I always check priority or ground advantage all the way through because sometimes you get a good deal ground advantage even though it's over a pound. So eBay, you always have customer pay shipping? No. In some cases, I do free shipping. It really depends. If right now what I'm doing is if I list an item and it's $30 or lower, I'll do plus shipping. If it's $30 or higher, I'll do free shipping. I'm going to interview before the show. I'm going to go do this interview before the show. See you there. Peace out, Desti. Desti's doing big boss things right now. She's going to do an interview. And I hope the person you do an interview with loves blue cheese. I think you should always ask them that question like, hey, do you like blue cheese? And if they say yes, you know, you're probably going to not hire them immediately. You're going to be like, nope, you're not for me. Sorry. You ship shoes in a box. You have original box? Yes, I put that box inside of a box. You do not take, Chris actually showed me a video the other day of a shoe box he got from I think you ordered it from like China or something like that. And they literally just took the label and slapped it on top of the box and taped the outside of the box. Please don't do that. Put them inside another box and then ship them out that way. Interesting, even on clothes. What do you mean by that reselling nostalgia? Are you talking about the labels? I lost track. He walked in with headphones. Yeah, he probably likes blue cheese. That's how it happens. T-minus 16 minutes until the Whatnot Show. Everybody go bookmark the show. Again, it should be a lot of fun. When you filter solds for eBay and then click free shipping, majority of the sold comps are free shipping. He's made a ship with his method, everything regardless of the price. Yep, 100%. Free shipping on clothes, or do you charge now? I charge shipping on clothes if it's $30 or under. I'm doing a lot of the Surf's Up method. So for like Ralph Lauren shirts, you guys saw me sell a couple of those today. I do plus shipping on those. So instead of listing them for $30 flat, I'll do $22.99 or $24.99 plus shipping. And I've actually been selling a lot more that way. I'm kind of changing my method all because of Surf's. Amazon does that for shoes. I got name brand shoes. Yeah, that's crazy. That's crazy. How do you ship shoes without the box? You just put them into a shoe box. There's an actual box made by the post office. I don't have it. It's out in the garage. Actually, I do have one. This is a return. So it looks just like this. And there's literally a pair of shoes inside here that got returned. But yeah, this is what they look like. You just put them in one of these, add some padding to them, and you ship them out. Shoe boxes. Good morning. And Aaron, I actually got to head off. We're going to do the Whatnot Show in 15 minutes. I got to go set up for it. Appreciate you guys hanging out. I'll be live tonight. If you guys order anything today during the Whatnot Show too, we're going to try to ship it out today too. So you're literally going to get one day handling in, out, gone. So I'll see you guys there. 15 minutes, Whatnot Show. Appreciate you guys hanging out. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.